Hey everybody, this is JTB.
And this is Bogowski.
And we are back for everybody's favorite chapter. My favorite chapter. Your favorite
too.
Chapter. Everybody's favorite. Chapter 4 on a Karma Run.
Until the next one.
Although, I say that, having played more of this run, because as I said, like I'm further than this run would lead people to believe, I'm going to change my stance on this, my long stance. Chapter 6 is the worst. Chapter 6 is actually the worst chapter on a Karma Run. Fuck that chapter. but this fight, you can get two UTs and an ET here with the blue. Again, that's literally just play it until you get the blue. It is very annoying to grind that out. But it's super simple to get two UTs if you just want to kill the first guy. And then, you know, UT the black guy. It's really straightforward. So you don't need to guillotine throw him there. I just thought it was funny. I just love the guillotine throwing the enemies. And then just throw him down here, and then flying swallow. When you go past that little grate where I just went past right there, that's when you will actually cut off that fight and despawn the essence. Which is why I like using the guillotine throw as opposed to arrows, because it's annoying to, you know, kill him with arrows and then despawn the essence and then cut it off.
God, what an asshole that guy was right there.
Yeah, he's very, very, very rarely is he that aggressive with the grenades.
Right.
Usually, as soon as you hit that black guy, he comes towards you. But ideally, like, I wanted low health going into this next fight anyway, so it didn't really matter.
You got it.
And yeah, I still got the points. But yeah, man, they hurt. Like, those grenades really do a lot of damage.
I was really surprised at that.
So this fight right here, there's a little bit of history before we get onto this fight. This took me about, I think, 7 hours to get this. And this is not what I wanted. I had a lot of strategies in mind that I really wanted to play out and really kind of just see what you could do. Because the positioning, the spawn patterns, the enemies that you get, the inconsistent health on these soldier guys, it makes this fight an absolute nightmare to play for the absolute maximum amount of points. So what you see here is not actually the maximum you can get. So you want to start off here, get two guys to spawn, jump over to this guy, and use the Lunar UT. Make sure you take off Armlet of the Sun. The activation Nimpo will kill the black guy. All being well, he'll give you a blue. All being well, that white guy was supposed to give me a blue there, but he didn't. So this would be a UT, and I'd still have two essence out to UT again. But at this point, I'd tried this encounter literally probably 500 times, and I didn't get it. So I just decided to take what I got here. That flying swallow, if it had killed the black guy, would have been nice, but it didn't. So again, I can just fiend sealer him. Ideally, I would have an ET out here, so I could ET through him, scoop him up, use that blue for a UT, and then I'd have 5,000 extra, basically. But that didn't happen.
Wow.
Yeah, it's annoying, because I got right to the end of it, and then I realized that that was what you could get. But it just took so long for me to even get that one pattern. I thought, screw it. Like I'm not like I'm not grinding that out anymore. So just go in there and kill these. Now this is actually quite a different pattern than normal. Because I didn't decide to go for like that crazy pattern on that fight right there. I decide to do these four fights actually in a row. So I do this one, the one before it, and the next two, all in one gauntlet. And that saves me having to go back here and go all the way back to the start of the chapter and save. That saves me a bunch of time later in the chapter, so I can save after all the annoying ninja fights, which is a lot more useful in my opinion. Yeah, they're just more annoying. I mean, if you're going for that pattern that I wanted, definitely go back and save after the fight before this one. If you get that, you know, that entrance to the military bit, if you get that the way you can, just go back and save and just deal with this gauntlet, because if you do and it goes wrong, I mean, the amount of times it takes to get that, yeah, you'll see coming up. But so just kill this guy with the arrows, wait for him to just, you know, dissolve, grab his money, and then you just want to respawn these guys. You can respawn them really quick. You only have to come like out of here and get up to the door right here and then just come back and they'll respawn. So don't look at him straight away. Just hold down B and then just kill the Grenadier. And then I'm going to spawn, you know, these two guys afterwards and then do all these fights in a row. And again, this saves you a ton of time having to backtrack later on. And it's not too bad of a gauntlet either.
Well, that's a lot easier than trying to no look attack.
Yeah, I've never been... I've never been a fan of no-look attacks, to be honest. Like, it's just annoying. You know sometimes when you're doing it, and the enemies will come just into frame and start the time limit, and you haven't got your UT yet, and you think, you little bastard.
I like no-look attacks. You just kind of went, yeah.
So, like, wherever possible, like I always prefer to just chain a UT, because you're always going to get it, you know, if you chain it.
Well, you're a fighter. I'm a hider.
So, yeah, just do that. That does look like a pretty crazy gauntlet, and it is, but if you're going for that one UT less strategy on the military bit fight, it's actually not too bad. So here's a bonus clip for you. Sorry to play you guys a little bit. But
loopers are fun.
Here is this pattern right here. This is the pattern you want. I actually did get it. Sorry to play to the crowd a little bit, but you know. So hey. You kill him, aura activation, everything I just said, just kind of, you know, I actually get it. He gives me a blue. The guy comes right at me, look. He's running towards me. You have no idea how many times I got this, and that motherfucker would just stand there and shoot me, and he wouldn't come up to me. but the real surprise is at the end, because in order to get this, watch what actually has to happen. You have to burn your talisman to get this UT, because that hitting him triggers him to drop his grenade launcher, so you can go over, and I mean, look at the time. Look at that,
wow.
50 points. And you know what happened after that? I did the fight after it, and the second black guy didn't come towards me. So I didn't get two ETs and an ET. So I had to restart. And I'm sorry, everybody, but I did not have it in me to do that fight again. But there it is on video, at least.
Would you be willing to use a rebirth at that point for 5,000 points?
I mean, when that happened, you know, like, it was a real kind of, a realization. I thought, oh my god, yeah, that's it. Burn your talisman. Because we've said it before, but, like, on very hard, you've got to understand, like, your items just mean nothing. Because on the high difficulties, you get so much money on these chapters. I mean, already in the chapters that I've done, I've had to burn, like, 10 grand just to keep my essence in line. So, you know, burning a talisman is nothing on very hard, you know, because you just get so much money. And again, you know, it's like Devil Elixirs. Sometimes you might need to burn, like, you know, two great Devil Elixirs to get an extra few thousand points. But because, you know, those items aren't really going to do anything other than that, you know, you might as well use them. So you can just chain from the rat to this fight here. Sometimes that ET will actually kill that Grenadier, which is very odd. If it does, you won't be able to get this pattern. This pattern as well is actually pretty tough. This took me a few goes of, like, practice and actual getting the spawns right. Because if they spawn in any different pattern than what you see there, your essence won't end up in that pattern at the end. So you'll end up absorbing three at once, and you won't have the extra essence to get that last UT on the captain.
You know, it's interesting when you hear people talk about, oh, it's not that hard, just play to reset it to get what you want and all that. But just to hear how technical all of that is for 5,000 extra points or 2,000 extra points, I mean, it's...
Yeah, it's kind of crazy.
it really is.
It is, yeah. It is
it's
kind of
so
insane.
Much easier to not have to worry about that. But then again, it's like, well, oh, that guy only beat me by 200,000 points. Well, that 200,000 points was a lot.
Yeah. This fight is also really annoying. Cat fiends and ninjas is probably one of the most annoying combinations of enemies in the game. Because smoke bombs are generally pretty effective on ninjas, but cat fiends tend to just not really give a toss about your smoke bombs. I mean, look how close that cat fiend is to me. And I dropped two smoke bombs. So sometimes they can flip out of that forward Y with the Luna, but because you have so much time in this fight, you might even be able to get another ET in this fight, honestly, if you really wanted to. Because I finished with, like, what's that, 3.4? So maybe you could maybe get another ET there. But again, the fight before it is quite tricky to get. But yeah, cat fiends are just really frustrating because they tend to just not really care about your smoke bombs. And having them with a ninja
hot.
Is... Well, yeah, you know what I mean. They don't care about smoke bombs.
Cat fiends are hot.
It's okay because that makes it okay.
They look good.
So then just go and save. So right here, I save pretty heavily for the rest of the chapter, and that's because I saved that time going back. I did time it, and I probably had it written down somewhere. Off the top of my head, I think it takes about 90 seconds to go back and save after that fight in front of the military base. So to save an extra minute and a half in this chapter for just doing one more fight in a row, like, to me, that's definitely worth the trade-off. Especially as fights that you do really aren't that difficult. So,
right.
I say that, you know, someone's going to try.
Well, you know, having that peace of mind, you know, the points are, you know, you might lose points down the line by doing that save. I mean, there is a trade-off to these.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. You
know, save opportunities. It's just whatever people think is best for them.
Yeah, and it depends on what kind of score you're going for, you know? Like, if you're going for, if it's your first karma run, you know, definitely don't go for the world record on your first, not on your first one out. So this fight, again, super simple, just chain essence from the rat. It's actually really handy when the black guy, like, comes towards you, but annoyingly enough, he just stayed there, and he actually wasted a bit of time there. Fortunately, I still make the time limit, but again, you know, I'm down, you know, maybe 100 or so points, just on the kill bonus there.
For the next guy.
The next guy's got to get that third fight that way too.
Oh yeah, true. Yeah.
Man, that fight, man, that took years off.
And that's,
I'm telling you.
Oh yeah, that's what's going to irritate you the most. It doesn't matter what kind of score you got. It's like I missed what I wanted to do. Yeah.
Well, it's the way it affects your the thing for me, and it's always been this way. It's the way it affects your numbers that nags me. Like right now, missing that 5,000, I don't care. But as soon as I get up to, like, 3-6, that 5,000 will annoy me. Because I think, oh, if I'd have got that UT, I'd be at, you know, 4-0 instead of 3-9. You know, and it's just the thing where that looks like such a higher score. Just because you're in the next bracket, you know. But again, you know, it is really frustrating. Even though it's not that big a deal. So this fight, you can actually get 3 UTs here. But with the health on the captain guys, it just really drove me up the wall. And I was really running low on patience here in this chapter, so I decided to just get the 2 UTs and an ET. So you basically want the opener that I did. But all being well, that UT wouldn't kill the first captain guy. And then you'd activate Inferno Nimpo. And then the activation would kill the guy you UT'd. And then the fireball would kill the other black guy, and then you'd just do 2 lunar UTs on the last guy alive, and then, you know, that would be your 3 UTs.
That's such a good move right there.
Oh, the Y counter?
The counter Y, it's fun to watch, just and the sound it makes, too.
Yeah, it's one thing I do miss, though, on NGB is in NG2, you know, they added that you could take that into a gleaming blade, and that was just one of the coolest things they did in NG2. So that right there, he just kind of came right through my smoke bomb, which I was actually quite surprised at. And because I knew the smoke bomb was still active, I could fiend sealer him. And you have a little bit of extra time in this, so I could still get my 3 UTs. I was only really bothered about getting 3 UTs here. You can definitely get an extra ET out of this fight. I think you have 24 seconds on the clock. So you could definitely get another ET if you wanted to.
So that was your Zuna drop. So what was your guillotine throw came from what, Muramasa?
I think guillotine throw.
I mean, from Masakata?
No, guillotine throw is Muramasa, I think. I think I got that in chapter
3. No, counterattacks.
Counterattacks was chapter 3, yeah. That's in the chest after the bridge room. Yeah, so right now, me not having that 5,000 drives me crazy. Because I'd be at 6.92 instead of 8.7. So that's when it bugs me. Is when it would take my score into the next one. So I like using that Y counter there to chain essence. As you can see, that black guy gave me a yellow. And if he'd have given it, I would have only chained that. It would have been an ET. So it's a really nice way to get 2 essences. So this is right. So funny how that misses me, even though it blatantly hits Ryu. But it just doesn't hit me for some reason. So sometimes the game pays you back, you know.
Yeah, nothing wrong with getting a little lucky every now and then.
So again, that runs the timer down super low. I think you have like 19 seconds for that. And again, the bare minimum for 3 UTs is 18 on the clock. And that's with like absolutely perfect charges on everyone. But as you can see here, you know, I can go back and save after all these fights. So I can just get that, you know, get those UTs, come back and save. It's fine. I don't have to worry about gauntlets or doing, you know, tons of fights in a row. Because, I mean, if you had more time, it's really weird, you know. If time wasn't a factor at all, karma runs would not be anywhere near as stressful as they are. If you could just save after every single thing you did and not worry about it, you know, it'd be...
That would kind of take some of the fun out of doing it, then, I think.
I think fun's the wrong word, but yeah, I know what you mean. Like, it would take some of the satisfaction out of doing it, I think, maybe. So for this fight, just jump forward. You can just about make out a little line on that like separation part there on the blue floor. And when you cross that, that's when the guys will spawn. So just, you know, charge up a Luna UT and just let it go. And then you can get... three UTs and an ET in this fight. And I like to swap over to the Dragon Sword just because in this environment, even on very hard, you know, you're very likely to hit more than one enemy with the Luna. So you could kill both of them.
Nice counterattack into the forward Y.
Quick note on that, if you want to rewind the video, you'll see they do spring up just a little bit faster when you do that for some reason. I don't know why, but they always do. So you need your essence out in order to get a UT when you do that. You know how normally you can XY them and they're down for so long where even if your essence is just coming out, you still have time to charge? If you do a counterattack on the first hit of the XX counter string and then forward Y, and then charge, your essence like needs to be out to guarantee that UT. Unless they roll, but again, they're not guaranteed to do that.
Wow, there's just so much I still don't know about this game.
Man. I need to do like a Trivial Pursuit for NG.
Oh man, I fail.
make a Trivial Pursuit for all the random stuff in this game. So I'm leaving my Luna at level 1. Smoke Bombs are 500. I think they're... Are they 650 on Master Ninja? Maybe?
Oh, I don't think it's a 50. I think it's a 0 or 600.
Yeah, so it's either 600 or 700, but again, you know, do that times 15. You know, smoke bombs are getting pretty pricey on the high difficulties, so you're not always guaranteed to be able to just fill them up. So just buy as many as you can with the essence you have at the end of a chapter, and then it's always good to have as many as you can going in, because odds are you're always going to need smoke bombs, especially in these early chapters, you know, on man-sized enemies. Like, you're always going to need smoke bombs on a karma run. On the later chapters, it's not too big of a deal. Like, zombies, you know, you don't really need them for that, so you don't need to worry about it too much on those chapters. But on these ones, just get as many as you can.
Well, you know, even if you don't use them for a karma run, they're still very helpful.
Oh, they're totally broken in combat. So I'm glad I got that on video. He was trying to be sneaky. He was trying to be a cheeky sod. You can delay that helm splitter move. As you can see, I'm in air, but I wait for him to be underneath me and delay the input so that I know that's going to ground him and then I can launch him again. But yeah, I was really shocked when he dodged that, because I mean, he was in recovery frames right there and he just didn't care. I was like, nope, I'm off. Don't care about your move.
Well, you know, sometimes the game does what it wants when
exactly.
We, you know, don't think it should.
Exactly. So that's it for Chapter 4. Definitely don't go for the patterns I did, unless you want to lose hair. The time limit's 17. Kills are 52. Kills is pretty easy because you're going to be farming kills anyway. And again, I still had a little bit of time left and some essence to burn. So you could either, you know, go and buy some stuff at Muramasa if you wanted to. But that's it for this one, guys. We'll see you in Chapter 5. Hope you enjoyed it.
Take care, everyone.